My personal favorite of Can't Hang Out is if I hang out Marilyn Manson, it's still going to look weird. It's going to look like he, although it looks like I'm his fat son. He's got to have been ashamed of all these years.
That's funny. This is Jay Manson.
We're both wearing black lipstick.
This is my son, Jay Manson.
Hey. Hey, guys.
This is
my dad, Marilyn.
Are you ready for dinner, Jason?
Son, you're dating now. Are you using condoms?
Yeah. I told you. Good. You have to be 25 before I'll remove your ribs so you can suck your own dick.
I think there should be like thinking questions for actually Marilyn Manson himself, and that's his answer.
Yeah,
like, Dad, can I get $2,000 to go to spring break with my friends? I know what that means. It's going to be a no.
Hey, Dad, you got my white contacts?
Dad, can Jeffrey stay over this weekend?
That corset you wore during the Beautiful People tour, where is that?
Dad, my friend just bet me. Just tell me right now, did you or did you not get a whole fist in Rose McGowan? I told you, Jeffrey. Absolutely.
That's just going to be a new segment, just like Bonfire Action News, just like the Blonde Hooies.
Just like Marilyn Manson's kid asked Marilyn Manson questions. Dad, can I go boot junk with Christine down the block?
Hey, Dad, are you parked behind me?
Dad, did you drink my orange juice? I put my name on it!
Dad, did you delete the DVR Monday Night Raw?
Dad, Mom wants to know if you sent the check yet.
Dad, did you gas up the lawnmower?
Dad, I got a couple things I need you to sign. Could you sign my test tomorrow so I can bring it in?
Marilyn Manson's son asking him questions will never get old.
Dad, is Debbie coming over for dinner? Is it just me and you? All right, cool, because I'm going to go hang out with Douglas.
Dad, can I take your car to school tomorrow?
Dad, are we having stovetop? Can Kenny come over?
Can you bring orange peels for the video for the game?
Dad, we're having everybody over for the UFC fights. Can you make chili? Yes!
You're the best, Dad!
I'll start off by telling you this. Marilyn Manson, it's done.
You're such a big Marilyn Manson fan.
Listen, that said, there's some people who have even tweeted at me and said, I'm seeing him right now, man. He's 100% on his game. I'll challenge that those people have never seen him really, like, at his best.
Oh, you're going hipster Manson.
Because
I knew Marilyn Manson before you.
I know.
Marilyn
I really
Manson.
Hate doing that, but I watched.
Oh, it's cool.
Time.
I do it with Queens of the Stone Age all the
time. I couldn't even let Christine just overly enjoy it because I just got to be there going, like, this is just fucked up.
Did he ruin it? Have you seen Manson before?
He didn't ruin it, but he was fat shaming him like crazy.
It was just such a bummer, man. It was. He just,
we're all fat now in the cake show.
In the cake show.
Hey, Dad, did you eat all of my ding dongs?
Dad, we're out of Pringles and I have like four friends over. Did you eat the Pringles?
Hey, shit. Did you drink all the soda in the garage? It never ends.
Yo, your dad's the worst.
Yo, I hate your dad, Jeff Manson.
Dad, where's the dog? Did you sacrifice him in a ritual? Oh, Fluffles.
Hey, Dad, did Mark walk in on you blowing yourself?
He's going to tell everybody at school.
Oh, I hate being your son.
Yeah, he just was like, I mean, Christine, you got to have some video of that, of his new, I mean, there's trails you can go on YouTube where they show you, like, multiple, just like, it's over.
So you, as a fan, did it take you out of the concert? Did you not enjoy the concert?
Nope.
You didn't enjoy the concert?
No. I didn't
enjoy the concert. Christine, did you enjoy the concert?
I did enjoy the concert, but I never saw him in his heyday, and I remember his performances, like, on the VMAs from his heyday, and it's just a different thing.
It's a different thing. Dude, first of all, he would always be, like, kind of gross. He'd do, like, a lot of gross things on stage.
Like what?
And it was kind of cool.
Because I find certain things gross that you might not find gross. Like, not texting people back to me is gross.
You're saying he displayed gross behavior traits?
Yeah. Empty promises are gross. What's gross to you? Marilyn Manson's just a bad person on stage?
No, dude, he's just, like, it's... Well, so all the gross stuff he used to do, like, he'd come out, like, he would, like, piss his pants. Like, purposefully.
But, like, that's hilarious.
It's the best thing ever.
Can I do that?
Oh, dude.
Hello, what's up, Tempe Improv? Good to be here, dude, for my opener.
This is when he was no bullshit. I mean, this is like...
What are you talking about?
This is 98 VMAs.
This is 98 VMAs. I mean, he was beautiful. And I don't mean beautiful in the sense it's the wrong music. There we go. It's wrong. It's the wrong... Oh, no, now it's right. Yeah. The marching band. Dude, this is... He was beautiful, and I mean that in the sense of...
Inside.
I mean, obviously, he wasn't, like, beautiful.
Nice and slender.
Yeah, but he just looked so fucking unique and awesome.
...to be oppressed by the fascism of Christianity.
All this bullshit. Like, he was
no
selling it.
...be oppressed by the fascism of beauty. Because I see you all sitting out there trying your hardest not to be ugly. Trying your hardest not to fit in.
I mean, he was beautiful.
Trying your hardest to earn your way into heaven.
I don't know who this guy is, but I don't like his sass.
You want to be in a place that's filled with a bunch of...
assholes. Oh, dude, he went for it so hard. Here's when his butt cheeks are out, remember?
I'm peeing my pants right now, MTV.
Just taking a hot whiz. No, but I see him pee his pants. He blows. He's big on blowing snot rockets and all
that
shit.
Yeah, dude, he should hang out with my uncle.
Which a lot of rock stars do, by the way.
And football coaches.
Yeah, a lot of rock stars blow the snot rock on stage. But he does the Antichrist Superstar song that I modeled my whole intro of my special off of.
Yeah.
The Antichrist Superstar thing. Where he's up on the podium, where he's flopping over the podium. He can't really flop on the podium anymore because he's chubby and he might hurt himself or fall.
Is he just winded?
No, he just can't. Like, it's not the same dude.
Well, he's older, man.
So much older. Yeah, but this was one that, you know what? I'd hate to say that. I think this might be the one act where he had to stay young. Although we watched very briefly at my house today when you came over, we watched a little bit of the crusty the end concert.
We watched
Motley Crue.
We watched Motley Crue's documentary, The End, and they
watched a little bit of it.
Oh God, interviewing the people in the fucking before the show and in the parking lot. There's nothing better than hair metal fans that have stuck with it.
And just find him doing Beautiful People now.
That's what I'm looking for.
I mean, dude, he's grizzled.
As grizzled as the Motley Crue fans.
Yes.
I saw them in Reno, Nevada.
Well, he's 47.
In 1988.
I think he's 47.
And I remember I did a cap of meth, and then I went in the place, and I fought a cop. I won. I looked good, too. I was in leather pants, long hair.
Just make up words. It was a rip dinger of a show.
Yeah.
If she finds him doing Beautiful People now, it's such a fuck. Yeah, here you go.
He looks great. She's got my body.
I mean, too. He's wearing a vest because he's too heavy to go shirtless anymore. Look at his jumps. His whole movements are just weird and blocky.
It's like when an old fighter gets too old for the foot movement, so they just got to stand and trade and like...
Yeah, but he's just... It's awful, man. Like, watching him lumber around the stage with his 47-year-old body is bumming me out.
Is it sadder than like when Ric Flair would wrestle?
Yes, it is.
It's sadder than that.
Yeah, this is a bit of hearsay.
Okay.
I'm going to say this is hearsay out of the gates here, but I think he's just like, he's 47, he's making his money. I don't think he really gives a shit about this music at all anymore. And he presents it as such. And he's just like, listen.
So do you think he should just go all the way and get super fat?
No, I think he should stop.
I think he should get super fat. Can I just say I want him to get super fat? I want him to get like 390 pounds.
Well, again, the hearsay is now he's also all whacked out on like fucking absinthe and shit. And
okay.
He's like just fucked up, so it's
fun.
Like he just kind of doesn't give a shit maybe anymore.
You know what? You're getting me on board.
You love him.
I like a less agile. I like a bulldog version of Marilyn Manson.
His new album did really well. For rock, his new album did great.
Okay.
It did very well.
Did you like it?
No.
You are just off board. This is your guy.
Dude, he's my guy.
And you're just not a fan anymore.
He's 100% my guy, dude. I love him.
No, you don't. You're shitting on him.
It's not the same, man.
You don't like him the way you don't like British comedy.
Oh, I do not like I do not like British comedy. But Marilyn Manson is done.
He's done.
It's done. He's still my favorite. He's still my favorite of all time.
What if he dropped weight?
Yeah,
and just got like back to pissing himself.
100%
Smashing kittens.
100% I'll be right there.
You'll be right there.
I'll be.
What if he looks
right
over at you
there
and goes, "You don't love me. You didn't love me when I was fat."
I'll accept that, and he's right. I shouldn't have done that thing.
Oh, Jay's back.
Maybe that's a thing I shouldn't have done. But in the right now, I gotta say he should stop. It's not good.
I don't think you say stop as much as lose weight.
No, stop.
You want him to stop.
Get it together.
Get it together, Mary.
And then come back if you want. But this has to stop.
I don't even know who you are.
He's got a weak chin and a fat neck now. and it looks so weird.
What does he look like?
Just pull up pictures of him, Christine. You can see this guy. He's a bummer. But do before and afters. He was beautiful. He was so cool looking.
He does not.
Lou, back me up. You're never a Manson fan. You were never. Not, you can't be a fan of the Jam and Manson.
Yeah, you can.
I can't. But I like the theater of it all, and I can see that it's not the same. But
so look at that picture right there. That's a great picture right there. Exactly. You're like, oh, he's so cool looking. Almost like a woman. Like a pretty woman. Bring up the video for Long Cold Road Out of Hell, Christine. Bring that up and play that song, actually. Sneaker Pimps Marilyn Manson. Dude, he looks like a beautiful woman. And it's so cool, the video.
And but now what? Now
in fact,
like,
I'll suggest anyone who's follows us on Twitter or does or watch this video. This video is insane.
And this is still when he's cool, sleek, and slender.
Oh, this is the height of his cool, sleek, and slender.
I don't know if
the whole band. The whole band's a bunch of grizzled out. It's just bad.
What do they look like, Jimmy? They look like a couple of dorks.
Look at that.
Okay, yeah. I get it.
You see what I'm saying? Like, he's making that cool. He's wearing a fucking negligee, women's lace gloves, and his hair's all done up like a chick. But he looks awesome still. Do you get what I'm saying?
Yeah, I mean, I don't know if
You're saying yeah, and like you're going to deny that, but you're look at your face watching it.
It's great. It's a great video.
It's so good.
I just feel like he's your friend's elaborate brother, where you're like, all right, I got it. You're weird.
Oh, yeah. But he was beautiful.
Yes. Now pull him up.
And pull him up now.
I want to see what he looks like now. Now that Jay's got this crush out, now I see why his crush. Now he looks like, leash.
Yeah.
Oh, God. He looks like a German DJ.
Yes. Dieter.
The way I disco dancing.
Look at him.
Oh.
It's just a bummer. So you can't tell that's a bummer, right?
Yeah, it looks like an evil drug runner.
Josh Homme looks exactly the same.
Yeah.
He's from aged, the fucking early 2000s to now.
Josh Homme's aged gracefully.
Exactly the same.
Yeah.
And you can still love that.
I love him
if you love
for other reasons.
If you love the Stones, yes, in the fucking 60s.
Love the Stones.
You can still love them now.
There's actually something more lovable about the fact that they're all these little wrinkled old men.
But he didn't change anything for except their aging.
But if Keith Richards would have got fat, that would have been adorable.
Listen, look at that. Look at him. Look at naked Marilyn Manson. Dick's all tucked.
Dude, that is the funniest thing to bring up to tell a guy why to like a man. Look at him.
Dude, look at his body.
Look at
his,
yeah.
Look at his sleek lines.
Yeah, it's just like a hairless cat.
Oh, so he fucking, what you call it? So he, where the all the gross shit used to be so cool.
Yeah. And again, this is physically gross, not emotionally gross.
Physically gross. The snot rockets, all that shit. You're like, not that you want to. I certainly would. Oh, look at him, Soder.
Oh.
Not that I would have ever wanted to get hit by it.
He looks like Bono's retarded brother.
Yeah, dude. He looks like he's melting. And look how cool he used to look. You know what else? He's too lazy. He doesn't even wear the eye anymore. And that bums me out. He doesn't wear the.
At what point do you think he was leaving his house? And like, Marilyn, you're going to put it in your eye? And he goes, it's not even worth it anymore.
Yeah, who cares?
Why? I'm 50 pounds
but
overweight.
But he just did it fucking right.
Big J doesn't want to fuck me anymore. What's the point?
All the posing.
What's the point?
All the stage posing and all that stuff. Like, it's just, he doesn't even do it anymore.
Because he knows that you're not into it anymore, Jay. He knows that you're not as turned on.
I hope to God that I have the power that he felt the energy I was giving off when he was doing that show because.
And now it's a training montage?
I was mentally past my Chicago shows, and they were great. I had a blast in Zany's, Chicago.
Yeah.
Rosemont and downtown. I had a blast. You should see, Christine, if anyone put up a video from what I'm about to describe, the thing at Chicago Open Air, Antichrist Superstar song. So he goes up on that podium, and he blows a snot rocket, and the camera guys happen to be right up on him when he does it, like in his face.
Yeah.
On the big, big screens. And he blows a big one, and it hangs on his lip. Look, just look, if you do Manson's snot rocket, I bet you can even find it.
Oh.
Actually, type in the word snot rocket.
I did.
Yeah, I mean,
hangs
on his lips. I was excited to come in today.
What?
I was all fucking excited.
I was all fucking ramped up.
I wanted to talk so much about this whole week about Manson. You know,
Marilyn Manson.
Marilyn Manson.
Fat Manson.
Fat Manson.
That's our new song for him.
It's 80s. In the style of 80s, 80s pop.
Yeah, it's 80s guitar rock.
It's Manson. Fat Manson.
He went from skinny to fat. Now he's Fat Manson.
He put on some LBs. Fat Manson.
Put him in leather and he pops out. Fat Manson. Climbs on the stage. Now he's almost dead, Fat Manson.
When he cuts himself, the gravy pours out. Fat Manson.
I love that. I could do this for the whole show.
By the way, Fat Manson.
You got to do the back and forth. You have to do the addicted to love dance. Fat Manson.
That's the look of Fat Manson.
Dude, why is it fucking hot as shit in this room?
72? Come on, dog. Change that right now. Let's get that bitch down to 65.
58!
58!
Derek Thomas, rest in peace!
Oh, Fat Manson!
Talking about Fat Manson, doesn't do cardio, eats real bad.
A show that I would have been at had I not been out of town for work.
Yeah, I mean,
Ballroom.
This is, can I just say before we get into this, this is the most bonfire topic of all time.
Mm-hmm.
Where it goes, because we know where it's going. But I'm saying at the start, with Marilyn Manson getting injured.
The only thing that would make this any better is if somewhere in the background of a video, you could just see, like, Josh Homme taking a piss or something.
Yeah, where he's pissing, he goes, did Manson just fall? You go, hey, hey, Dad, you're not going to crawl on the stage tonight, are you? Okay, I just get real nervous because you've been eating a lot, and I just don't know if, like, okay.
Promise me no matter what, you do not climb your own stage props. It's just, no, it's because you know Kyle made them, and Kyle's not, he's just your dealer.
They're just... You know it's just an art exhibit, right? It's not like bolted down or anything.
Why was it not bolted down? It's such a great question. Why was it just not handled in some way?
Where they're like,
you know, you can the thing is so clearly front heavy. So to explain what happened, Marilyn Manson during a show at Hammerstein Ballroom during the song Sweet Dreams decides, I'm feeling 22 years old again.
I'm all ramped up.
And goes, I'm going to climb this extremely front-heavy stage prop, which is...
Okay, well, real quick, though, it's two guns.
It's so front-heavy.
It's two guns back-to-back, and hold on real quick. Can I just say there is something... I hope Marilyn Manson's okay, but there's something incredibly hilarious about someone trying to be evil and then taking a shitter like that, like where you're like,
is it me, or do you want the devil inside of you?
Oh, God!
Yes. He goes, I'm going to climb up here like a satanic Jesus. And, oh, God! Oh, God, is this thing going? Is this... Get it off! Justin! Get it off! Justin!
New York, come with me to hell!
Oh, wow! New York City, America's Satan stands before you at the... that's a heck! Oh, God, I'm not walking on that.
City.
I'm not putting any pressure on that.
Oh, New York City, are you ready for your modern antichrist?
I'd like to thank you first and foremost, the stagehands who built these amazing... Whoa, 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 whoa! Ah, ah!
Do you like my double guns? Blazed in hell by Satan's hammer. Oh, well, dude, it's coming out. Tim, 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 tim.
Can I warn the guitar player? Let's play the video because he climbs it. And oh, jeez.
Christine, by the way, another one to have fun with that, too. Christine just wisely brought up Madonna when she fell on stage when the cape got caught and like that is also really funny. She goes,
yeah,
all of my worshipers, are you ready to dance? Okay, Christ on the cross. I'm going.
I remember watching that.
She's like, all of you who have been hated on because you can't be gay.
We are all beautiful creatures of God, and if you don't like that, you can go straight to son of a bitch.
I'm going ass first.
Yep, I'm going.
I'm going right down, right on my putter.
I can make it even more that she's talking. She goes, guys, do you think this... Is this cape not pinned on right? God damn it. God damn it.
She goes, and also, okay, hold on, guys. Is this knotted in? Why say, hey, Mark.
Am I crazy or am I attached to this cape? Like, I feel like when you pull it off, like, I'm going with it, right? Yep. It's attached.
No, it just feels, odd. Like, I'm up.
She goes, I'm okay. Oh,
after she gets pulled, she goes,
she goes like, I'm not 20 anymore. I am gonna feel that tomorrow.
She goes, that's a stinger. No, it's just a stinger.
But okay, anyway, come on, Vogue.
Striker, pose.
Dietrich and DiMaggio.
All right, let's go back to Marilyn Manson.
Yeah, Marilyn Manson.
Shit with his double guns. Because where this goes is even better.
Oh, it's great.
So Marilyn Manson, at the Bonfire SXM, Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat, to see the video of Marilyn Manson having his stage piece collapse on him, which are two handguns back to back.
It's been all over Twitter, but we have a pretty good one we're putting out here, which is HD. So check it out. Yeah, at the Bonfire SXM, go ahead and play it. So cool. Wow. By the way, I've seen him a couple times recently, and this looks like they, by all accounts, this show, he was killing it. That's why I probably think he felt like he was like a young kid again.
Someone doesn't, oh boy.
But man, isn't it funny? Look, isn't it crazy? Wait, come back. Is the ultimate sign that he's Fat Manson?
He turns around, he's turn around belly.
No, it's not that. It's when he turns around, you see, he's wearing a corset. He's like over a t-shirt.
Yeah.
Like a fat guy swimming.
Oh, dude, he's dressed like Keith the Tractor Trailer. He's got a t-shirt under his basketball jersey.
I mean, come cool. Yeah. He had Robert Trek.
Yeah. Trailer. Remember Brian Reeves, Big Country?
Yeah.
He'd always wear a t-shirt.
There's a t-shirt under his fucking, because you don't want to show like your weird pasty fucking body.
Or the stretch mark part of your fucking armpit.
Oh, yeah.
You don't want to show that.
But wait, unless you're jacked.
Yeah.
Then you don't care to show any of that. You're like, sure, man. Well, why do you think my body can't hold these muscles?
Yeah, those are ripples in an ocean.
my skin can't hold these fucking popping muscles.
If you got
wait, come back. Go backwards a little bit, Christy. I just want you to see in the light. I mean, he's wearing a corset over. You
know, he looks like an
over a long sleeve T-shirt.
Jay, when he turns to his side, he looks like an old butcher.
Like an old
Polish man that owns a fucking butcher shop.
He's good meat.
I cut the kibasa for you.
The marbling is top notch.
You see my double guns, my son and artist. Watch me climb it. Oh God!
My son Sergey built those.
And watch me climb. It's two guns to represent. Oh God!
Looks like he was having a great time in his fucking weird corset. High water pants. Yeah, the whole thing's all fucked up. Look at that, still a corset. It ties in the back.
Here he goes. He goes, I can climb this.
He's like, let me see. He goes, scaffolding, two guns, really front heavy. You know what, by the way? If he climbs the back of this thing,
he's fine.
He's probably fine. What an embarrassing thing to happen to Fat Manson.
Oh, when you eat too much and you're not the devil, Fat Manson.
When you deal with the devil didn't include weight control, Fat Manson.
When you love late night snacks and no cardio, Fat Manson.
Here it goes.
I mean, he's asking for this to happen.
Oh. Yeah.
So he falls backwards.
And he goes, and then he's got.
And then tries to kick his goes, tootsies up to, goes, to knock it off.
He goes turtle mode.
He goes in full blown, like, eek.
Turtle Manson.
Turtle right Fat Manson.
He goes, it's come right here is the best. Because he goes, oh God, it's coming down.
Oh my God, man. It's so goddamn funny.
Goes right for his ankle like an injured linebacker.
So then stagehands come out to pull it off.
He goes, I'm not evil. I'm injured. Stop touching me. Stop it.
Hey, everyone, Satan's got a bad wheel. Gotta close this thing up early.
Yeah, Satan didn't know he's gonna catch his wing in the door. God, it is. I don't think I've broke anything, but I'm bruised up bad.
The angel of death has been grounded, everybody. I am sorry, but this thing hurts.
Marilyn, can you walk on it? Can you finish the show?
Marilyn, I'm going to rotate your foot. You tell me when it hurts. Okay, sorry.
Hey, Marilyn, hi. I don't mean to tell you this, but there is a difference between playing hurt and playing injured. Now, either you're hurt or you're injured. You can't play injured. You can play hurt. Can you play? I just don't trust that with the insurance on this place. I think we're going to have to call the show.
But they called it off due to an injury. But I mean, what a funny thing to have to leave.
I mean, it's such. It's
by the way, you see him roll. He rolls over and grabs his ankle. Pretty good. You see that?
Yeah, but there's nothing more embarrassing than falling.
If we can time that noise to that happening when he flips over and holds.
There it is. Flip over. Hold
right there. It's a little before
1:45.
You gotta play it right here. Just for that split second when his head is up. That's so goddamn funny.
I mean, initially they were saying, like, I remember when it happened, and they were saying it was like a back injury, like it was really bad.
I wonder how heavy that thing was. It doesn't look very heavy.
I mean, they whip it right up. Like, three guys, it just...
I guess it's pretty heavy, actually. You see it moving, like, pretty dense. But his guitar play, I love how when they fucking fag out the musicians, like the evil musicians, like, get him some help! Watch when he comes over, the guitarist comes over,
and
every movie he makes is so, like, flamboyant, he, like, throws his pick, he's like, well, stop staying there and fucking call somebody!
He's the reason you eat at night!
Yeah, watch, go back to when the
guitar player first Marilyn Manson's
out.
Actual name?
Right here, watch the guitar player. You call someone! Get a fucking ambulance! You see the guy's fucking hurt!
Marilyn, it's me!
Get out of here! Marilyn. You're crazy, I'm not playing anymore!
What's Marilyn Manson's real name?
Brian Hugh Warner.
So he probably went, Brian! When it hit him.
Brian, no!
One of my favorite Manson things ever is when he was on David Letterman and he said that he talked about his father's name being Hugh.
Yeah.
Hugh Warner. And he goes, he goes, you think that's bad? He goes, it's my middle name. And he goes, Marilyn Hugh Manson. Say it like that, maybe laugh. So, Marilyn Hugh. So there is now a 45-year-old man in a corset over a T-shirt. Now has to be helped up by a bunch of guys named Gus who work for the local 84.
They go, how you doing? Actually, I'm a Bon Jovi guy. All right, let's get you a princess. look at you. You are squishy. What are you? You're like one of those bags of cookie dough, Pillsbury Doughboy.
Tell you something, the boss will be right back up playing songs.
Hey, I'll tell you right, Springsteen, I seen him fall off the stage, get back up, he thanked the ground. But that's just the boss. All right, you ready to play Cupcake?
Saw Tyler fall off scaffolding 1979, landed on his feet, finished the song, still holding the microphone.
I swear to God, Aerosmith was on enough blow, they had the agility of cats. Anyway, sweetheart, you want me to get some lipstick so you can go back on and sing your sad songs? Huh? I'm also a Presbyterian. I find your act deplorable.
Also, as a devout Presbyterian, I think everything you do is gross. Where's your
gross.
Satan now, sitting here with your broken ankle?
Hey, where's your devil beast? Is he going to solve your fucking... You going to salve your bad wheel? Get up, you pansy. Why are you wearing your sister's corset?
Hey, Frunzo, why don't you try to drag your own leg off this guy?
Hey, what do you belong to, a Jane Austen society? Why are you in this corset? Hey, Sense and Sensibility, let's get you up off the ground here.
Hey, someone get a... We need a shovel over here to pick Dangerous Liaisons off the floor.
Hey, you guys, I think this hooker from the Old West is injured.
He's just riling around. He's Marilyn Manson's like,
don't touch me. Don't touch me. No. I wouldn't want to touch the devil when he's hurting. All right.
Fucking hilarious. Hey, Dr. Frankfurter over here needs a...
Well, it didn't... I mean, when we heard about the Manson thing, we talked about it. But then it got even more bonfire-y.
Oh, when it took a real turn for the bonfire.
When the Feld Dog got into
just
it.
Chimes up. And someone sent this to us on, I'll give a credit at some point when I'm able to check it out, on who sent us this back and forth.
Because we're blocked, so we can't read any tweets from Feld Dog.
No idea. This
bonfire and all the bonfire members and top counselors have all been, it's a patch. It's a patch here at the bonfire for you to get blocked by the Feld Dog. But not by saying anything rude, just...
No, if he just goes, he realizes your association.
Yeah. It's not by going out of your way to be a dick. It's just by being associated.
If you start getting blocked by Roman and Sierra, also now I kind of have to say that has to hold some value to us also. Yeah.
Oh, a Roman and Sierra block? On Instagram, that's the highest. That's
on like the gram.
On the gram, that's a level of black belt.
And let me tell you something. Roman's trying to catch up to Sierra on the numbers on Instagram.
Is he?
I mean, he's nowhere near her.
No. She's got nowhere millions. Near.
Yeah, and he's got like 50-some thousand, I think. Dude. Or no, 150-some thousand. But he's doing pretty good.
But yeah, I mean, but like, the Feld Dog, we can't see any of his tweets.
We can't see. And Christine, have you checked if this is a chronological order here that's going from top to bottom?
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
God, I love you, Lou.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. So...
The bonfire is not blocked on Instagram.
Sierra. Yeah. All right. Yeah. I need that login info.
Really? That's so weird that we're follow blocked.
Follow her. You should follow her. And she's like, Roman, come in the room.
Oh, my gosh.
And they're still alive.
Oh, look at the feng shui.
I miss him.
Oh, right. You dig?
So, Marilyn Manson falls, and then on Twitter, you can read the article at musicmayhemmagazine.com. We're also going to tweet it out from at the Bonfire SXM, but Corey Feldman has taken to Twitter to slam Marilyn Manson after his on-state injury where a gun prop fell on top of Manson, crushing and trapping him under the prop. Well, that's not actually what happens when you see the video.
Not what happened, but it does fall on him. He kicks his feet up, but it says the prop is said to weigh hundreds of pounds. So, okay. It looked like it was pretty... When they picked it up, it was several guys doing it looked pretty heavy.
Can you see what Loudwire's tweet was? It's highlighted right there. Loudwire tweets out, breaking, at Marilyn Manson, crushed by stage prop at NYC show, gig canceled mid-set. So Corey Feldman responds to this long story. If you are just catching up, let's just say he brought it on himself. Hashtag publicity stunt.
Publicity stunt.
R, letter U, letter R. Guy replies, did he fake the fall? And Feld Dog says, no, I think it was planned for attention since his album isn't selling what he expected. I mean, he's just coming out talking
also,
shit.
Also, it didn't come out yet. The album's not out yet.
And then someone replied, like you, Corey, but his new CD is fantastic.
No, he's basically, I like you, Corey. Like you, Corey, but his new CD is fantastic.
Fair enough. I never said he wasn't talented. He's just a terrible human being.
What do you think happened between Corey Feldman?
Oh, there was a sex party, but with skinny, long-haired white dudes.
There's got to be some digging.
It does? You see why. Oh, boy. Well,
in this article?
They ask... tell us about the karma part. What happened? And Corey Feldman says, just read his book. If you want his version, countless times he's used my name to get publicity, or maybe ask my former angel. Long story.
Former angel.
Oh, now in the grasps of Marilyn Manson.
Oh, do you think, Matt, let's take some guesses. Do you think...
He took an angel.
He snagged one.
He snagged one.
He's like, why are you hanging out with this guy?
Does he even read books?
Let's do the girl talking to Marilyn Manson.
She goes, so your house, I get to eat meat? Okay.
Do I have to walk around all the time looking stupid?
You're not going to tell me I need to ascend a millennium.
Do you even have a favorite number? Oh my God, I'll come.
Please take me. Bite these handcuffs off me.
Well, and then John Bender asks him, terrible human, please enlighten. And Feldog says, might I add using Columbine tragedy for publicity? Hashtag cool dude. I mean, it was.
That's fucking foul. That's not true. He didn't do that.
I mean, everyone knows that
he was blamed for Columbine.
Dude, I'm from Colorado, and everyone knows Eric Harris and Dylan Klebold were inspired by Marilyn Manson to cross pattern shoot. Yeah, no, I've read.
No, but say, but that's what
fucked
came,
up his career.
But that's what came. His no, it didn't fuck up his career at all.
You fucked up his career, bro. Yeah.
That's what came at him, though. I'm saying.
Marilyn Manson got blamed for Columbine when he had nothing to do with it.
Yeah, like because they liked Marilyn Manson's music.
Yeah.
And they blamed his music and shit for.
Is that how I describe your musical taste? Do you have school shooter taste in music?
I'm into school shooter music.
J-Lo's, what kind of rock does J-Lo?
J-Lo likes school shooter rock. That's really should be described what I look at. School shooter rock.
So he wrote. And then Corey Feldman wrote. Oh wait, what's the one before it, Christine? Above Corey Feldman's.
Well, I'm just saying though, for using it for publicity, he didn't. He responded. And he responded wonderfully, and the only response I ever saw essentially was Bowling for Columbine.
Yeah.
Where he was approached. He didn't, like, audition for a fucking role in a documentary.
And then Corey Feldman wrote, not being rude, look up the definition. Henceforth, the letter Y, it's called a publicity stunt. Atheist, you spelled that wrong. It's spelled Satanist. And yes, he's very ill in the head. Corey Feldman just fucking hates Marilyn Manson.
He's fucking throwing some bombs here.
Karma. And then once someone tweets at him.
Derek writes,
karma, said the washed up drug addict who can't make headlines unless he cries wolf about being raped in his teens or fucks up a live performance of a song that will never be a hit anyways. Yo, Derek coming in with one of those samurai blades.
Yeah, Derek just jumped right in. Well, I'll say one thing I know for sure about Derek. The only thing I know.
He's a straight shooter?
No, he is currently blocked by Corey.
can we look that up? So,
this negativity will never show up again. That is for sure.
I wish we could. Yeah, Derek's definitely blocked. Well, then Corey Feldman responds, wow, somebody got their feelings hurt real bad.
Someone got their feelings hurt. What a dick.
Sorry. Didn't mean to talk about your Lord and Savior that way. Oh, actually, I did. Feldburn.
Let's read that. Feldburn.
Yeah, you got to read that back.
You got burned to the core.
Hashtag wow. No, but he goes, wow, somebody got their feelings hurt real bad. Sorry. Didn't mean to talk about your Lord and Savior that way. Oh, actually, I did. You start doing robot dances too. Such a he goes, let me read that again. He goes, hey, babe, can you cue up Ascension? I'm about to send off this fire ass tweet. Wow, somebody got their feelings hurt real bad. Sorry, didn't mean to talk about your Lord and Savior that way. Oh, actually, I did. Hit it. Suck my dick.
So another person, Mama Kin writes.
Really? Fucking hell, man. Yo, Corey Feldman, devout Hindu here. Karma really doesn't work like that. Self-educate before you hate.
Now, in all capitals, Corey Feldman responds.
Like a devout Hindu would be following or caring about Marilyn Manson. Thanks, guys. I needed that laugh.
I mean, whatever opportunity we give Feldog to crawl his way out and be a decent dude, he just keeps being the.
LOL.
Thanks, guys. I needed that. I like that he goes. He's being genuine. He's like, thanks, everybody. I really found a pretty low day.
One of the angels
that laugh helped.
One of the angels got out. I don't know if
she I think she's under the neighbor's house, but
I'm going to put out her favorite food. Hope she comes back. She likes
sparkles. Sparkle. Puddles.
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 Formerly known as Ashley. What's this?
So this goes back pretty far, Corey Feldman's hatred for Marilyn Manson.
Because
this is an expert from his Marilyn Manson's book, and this article is from Spin Magazine 1998, and it shows what Manson said about Feldman back then. It is pretty harsh.
What does he say?
So this is like a long time coming, too.
Oh, wow.
I read the whole thing, but this paragraph right here was really like...
Well, I want to say, before I read that paragraph, I just want to say I did see up there that he just describes him...
Okay, so we'll read both paragraphs. It says, and I guess this is from Marilyn Manson's book. What book?
Oh, it's A Long Haul, Cold Ride in Hell. It's
Marilyn, what's the name of your book? He writes, Corey was in a pseudo Michael Jackson sort of outfit that made him look stupider than any of his movies had ever made him look. And that's hard to achieve, especially after Dream a Little Dream, part 5, in parentheses. I felt like it was my duty to introduce Corey Feldman to Sherman Hemsley.
Sherman Hemsley, which is George Jefferson?
Yeah, whence I had known their artwork for so long. In order to shake hands, they had to reach over the head of Billy Corrigan, so his bald head became the bridge over which two heroes of my childhood, Mr. Jefferson and Dorky the Vampire Slayer,
I still don't know. I'm not understanding why we have Dan put on his glasses and read so far. I feel terrible every time we do it. I'm like, I can see it fine. No. I'll do the second
part. Oh, wow, look at that. You can really see it.
I continued to torment Corey afterwards, putting lipstick on him and introducing him to strangers because it is my duty to punch below the belt. I told him I was a big fan of that rap song that I saw him perform on television, which was among the shittiest songs ever recorded, yet still not cool enough by far to be the worst thing I have ever heard. When the movie started, Jenna Jameson kept making comments like, well, what are we going to do later? Are we going out to a bar? Are we going to hang out? You know,
this is all just going into Jenna Jameson. Okay, the paragraph is really like...
So this is the really thing about him really taking a hot shit on Corey Feldman. And his music. And his recorded music. But he said it was far to be the worst thing he's ever heard.
He said it wasn't cool enough to be the worst thing he ever heard.
Oh, that's true.
He says, which was among the shittiest songs ever recorded, yet still not cool enough by far to be the worst thing I'd ever heard.
Just non-memorable.
It's just an extra insult.
Well, I mean, he's nailing it.
Oh, yeah.
But I like that he puts this...
How great would it be if
I like writing this after you've already put lipstick on him and introduced him to people.
Yeah, I mean, that's like a prison move where you're like, this is my bitch. He got lipstick on him. Kiss him. Kiss him, Corey.
Kiss my pretty boy. Kiss my pretty boy.
Kiss my pretty boy. Kiss him. But
kiss him.
It would be a real bonfire achievement to have Marilyn Manson on the show and to go through all of Ascension Millennium track by track, to have Marilyn Manson's musician, you know. I mean, I know it's like kind of mean, but.
What is there a thing we can look up? Like,
it's funny.
Him with the angel?
Is it funny? Oh, Marilyn Manson and Corey's angel?
Is there a way to find out what that story is? Do some digging
if you can, Christine, because he took one of his angels.
Just ask my former angel.
Which former angel, Corey? We can't know because you blocked us.
Former Corey Angel and Manson.
New Fat Manson. Fat Manson took my angel.
Fat Manson takes your women. Fat like pies off a shelf. Fat Manson.
I got an angel and Fat Manson took her too. Fat Manson took her too. I raised her from a kid. I fed her every day. Fat Manson came and took my angel too.
But this is, it's just great that these two things have intertwined and we didn't even know about it.
I should have known. I read that book so long ago, but I wish it would have reminded me. But he's like, it's not the first time he's before publicity. I don't know if Corey Feldman gets you much publicity. Doesn't he say at one point that he did like him in Stand By Me?
Yeah, he calls him a hero of his childhood. Manson seems to be talking about Feldman the same way you guys do.
Yeah.
Loves him, and what the hell's wrong with him?
I wanted to come in today and show you time just kills all things good. And that my favorite of all time, Marilyn Manson, who I've never received any love back from for the record. So I don't feel too bad in this.
Which is weird because you're in the same circle. There's like, you know what I mean? Like Rob Zombie, there's just been crossover of you and Manson.
Yeah, and nothing.
Where it could get to him.
And that's fine. And I will say, and by the way, I'm going to get his new album. He just announced today he's releasing a new album September 11th. Real nice.
Okay.
Real nice, dude.
Yeah, edgelording into your 50s. Like, and I'm releasing it on the death of that little girl. You know,
birthday.
Just make it good. 420, but not because of the weed holiday, because of Columbine and Hitler.
I always have hope. I always have hope that it's going to be a decent album. The last one had a couple of good tunes on it, but you know, it's not. It's always going to be a couple of good tunes where when I was a kid, not even a kid, but you know, late teens, early 20s, I get a new Manson album and be like, what are going to be the classics off this?
Yeah.
What are going to be the songs that live on forever? And he did that pretty deep into his career, but I mean, then it just stopped. I think Personal Jesus might have been the last like big hit that he covered Personal Jesus.
Yeah.
But beyond that, I don't think he said anything other than some good songs here and there on the albums. But the new video came out today for the title song. By the way, great name. We Are Chaos is what it's called.
Right.
Great name. The song is just, I don't know, man.
Well, let's hear it.
Marilyn Manson. It's just not Marilyn Manson.
It's K-pop.
It's produced by Shooter Jennings.
Who's that?
And when you look at his thing, it's all over the place, like who he's produced. It's one of those, like, I'll just produce whatever. Go back to the beginning of it, Christine.
Waylon Jennings' son?
Yeah, probably.
Absolutely. 100%. You nailed it, Jacob. It's got to be what it is.
This is so go nowhere.
Eyes.
He's back to not wearing the contact again, which I don't like.
Oh no. What's weird is you can immediately think, like, this is like Marilyn Manson folk. It's like, kind of sounds like Manson, but it's him, like, playing an acoustic, being like, and I will be your Daisy Man. And la, la, la. Like, he starts playing a harmonica attached to him.
Yeah, exactly. Well, here's the thing. He's done, like, acoustic guitar kind of, like, songs that gotten big before in the past.
Unplugged? He does Evil Unplugged?
He's done some songs. I'm saying he's had some songs on albums that are very, like, softer, but they get big. And I haven't listened to the end of this yet. Maybe it gets big, but it just doesn't seem to change from this, like, I don't know, man. I just, like, it's not catchy at all.
It's kind of shiny, if that sounds weird. It's like shiny Marilyn Manson. Like,
listen to the chorus right here. Is it an arm waver?
Just a mystery. I could be your misery.
It also, it sounds like 30,000 other songs. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And it's just, I don't know, man. It's just, he ain't the same. He ain't the same.
That's a hard thing to pull off. Pulling off, I think we've talked about this, pulling off evil for a long period of time is as hard as it is to pull off hot. It's got a little bit longer of a shelf life because you're dark and into blacks, you know, and into, like, clothing.
Well, old evil goes away. It's like Ozzy Osbourne. Like, yes. You can't look at Ozzy Osbourne as scary evil anymore. There's a time when he was, like, you know, that kind of guy. And, like, Marilyn Manson, yes. Go to the end of it, Christine. Does this pick up at all? I tell you one thing, though. He has fully accepted his that he looks like that in his age, because he will show himself nonstop. Where I'm like, maybe it's time to throw some, like, you know, some animation or something in the mix, or people in the videos.
Maybe pull off a claymation video, huh, bud?
Yeah, like, you were the coolest looking thing in the video at a point. Now,
well, that's that's kind of the same along the same thing as, like, you can't be evil for that long. It's like, you kind of got to, he's he's been a regular guy, but then he's back to being an evil guy, and you're, it's like he's like the Undertaker. You're like, which one am I getting, bud? Are you the dead man?
Well, it's just like he's not a good. This thing isn't making like. I say meaningful songs, the wrong words. I do think that some of his songs are meaningful, several of them. But also, like, his thing is just, like, not to make a fucking folky song. It's like, make a folky song, and you got to come out of it totally, dude. Like, don't sure. don't look the way you look. You're still portraying that you're going to show up in concert and do Beautiful People and Get Your Gun and all that shit. And then it's like, you can do this and have everybody hold hands and put their hands in the air. It's just...
Because we are chaos. It's something like a David Bowie.
And we are,
and we kiss buttholes. But I get that because with my question to you is it one of those things where you're going to listen to the album multiple times and then by the time you like the album, you're like, yeah, We Are Chaos isn't bad because I do that with Queens of the Stone Age. Every time they put out an album, I'm always like, am I not going to like this? Or does this suck? And then I listen a bunch of times and I'm like, oh no, it's just like a different, they're just changing. They evolve.
Look, I'm getting the album and I have to be completely honest, which is annoying as hell to have to say, but I even just hearing it that second time, I like it more than I heard it the first time, but it's still just like, I don't know, man, it's not Marilyn Manson.
But I don't think that's what he can do. I think you can't go looking for that same thing that was, dude, Marilyn Manson was like a phenomenon in the late 90s with everything that was going on.
No, mid-90s.
Yeah, mid-90s. But I just know it for like as it went on in the late 90s with like Columbine being blamed on him and like all that shit, which gave him some like, whoa, do you know he burns a Bible on stage? And everyone's like, oh my God. And it was. And dude, you can't be that in 2020 with celebrities tweeting all the time and shit. And like,
I don't think there's that. I'm not worried about ripping up Bibles and stuff, but just something.
No, but I'm not. I don't think that's it at all. I'm saying he can't shock the way that he used to.
No, we're not
shocked that easily anymore. Like, we're literally watching Kanye have a mental breakdown. That's more evil than watching him be like, I've got a white contact in and I show my wiener that's soft sometimes.
Yeah, exactly. Now he's got to like make sure he gets enough fiber in the day.
Yeah,
not, like, you know, supposed to be Marilyn Manson's thing.
Yeah, dude, he's entered the sensible Marilyn phase.
Sensible Manson.
Sensible Manson. I have to have vegetables before my absinthe. I'm a sensible Manson.
Never take my pills on an empty stomach. Sensible Manson.
Yeah. If it's evil, then I give it a smile. Sensitive. Yeah, man, I don't know. I can't
live in the cold because it hurts my bones. Sensible Manson.
Move to Arizona because I'm getting older. Sensible Manson.
I prefer the heat more than the cold. I'm going to get a flat ranch out in Las Vegas. Sensible Manson.
Wish I could see my grandkids more. I'm Sensible Manson. But like Pearl Jam, Eddie Vedder got older in like we've talked about this before. He fell into his like older age where he's like, no, I just drink wine and I reminisce a little too long in between songs.
And look,
Josh Homme just looks like a desert mechanic where he's like, your master cylinder's shot.
Well, you guys are lucky because Eddie Vedder, Pearl Jam's it's like garage rock in like the sense of like it's guys they just put on like jeans, t-shirts, and go play music. There was a production that had nothing to do with it at all. You know what I mean? So if you're like me and the rest of the world and checked out on Pearl Jam after that fucking Versus controversy where there's a sheep on the cover, Vitalogy. Yeah, that's where most of the world just fucking jumped off after that. For some reason, DJ Lou's shirt was caught in the door, so he couldn't stop.
That's where I jumped on.
Yeah, that's what you joined on, dude.
All right, you're so fucking hipster, dude. And then same thing with Queens of the Stone Age. It's like they can age gracefully within it. Marilyn Manson's like, well, I'm not wearing the contact lens. By the way, I fear this all myself as 42 and the stuff that I wear and everything. You're like, when at some point are they going to be like, dude, you're fucking 55. Like, stop putting a scarf in your back pocket. You know what I mean? Like,
but actually at 55, it might serve of a purpose. You might be like, that might be like your drool thing. You're dribbling fucking.
Maybe, yeah. But I just think Marilyn Manson. Yeah, probably I will need those things. A bit.
You're just like, it's a hot day out. You go, whoa, Jay, did you know I was going to come in?
But Marilyn Manson's not gracefully going into this. He's still like, he could look his absolute worst, and he still has on like, he has to show up at the airport at 5 a.m. wearing like leather pants and yeah. have like blue makeup around his eyes.
Yeah, he has to look like a sick lady going to the emergency room.
Yeah, he has to look like a fucking old crack whore who just wandered in because she needs a fix and she's gonna pass out.
What album's lyrics do you have on your arms?
High End of Low, I think.
Oh, that's really towards the end.
Yeah.
You shouldn't end that with I think. They're huge across both your forearms. You should know what album that's from.
Yeah, well, no, I don't know what song it's from.
Which song?
I don't think it is from High End of Low.
Can we hear the song?
It's Four Rusted Horses. Oh, no,
that's
it
the
is.
Song is you know, Four Rusted
you're right,
Horses.
That is the album.
I don't even know the song. But what album is this? How late is it?
High End of Low. It's like three or four albums ago.
No. It's like
I think it keeps cranking out
It's
albums,
like the sixth so. Album, I think.
What yeah. year?
It was like 2 years ago.
It was this
2012,
week.
2012, maybe?
What?
Yeah.
Is that late?
Yeah.
Was there something about that song that spoke to you?
I don't know. Read his forearms.
Let's hear it.
That the tide hearts had broke. Everyone will come.
I know the song.
It's a good song.
Will come to my funeral to make sure that I stay dead. Everyone will come. Everyone will come.
You're such a goth chick.
Here it comes, dude. Here it comes.
Hold on. Hold up. Hold up.
Pull the camera. Pull the camera close on.
Oh, you stink. I love it. I love that you own it. You fucking stink.
I wish you had a zoom on that camera.
Wait, let's go. You don't even have the.
I can see the coffin shadow.
Show the camera.
I don't think they have zoom.
Must have missed the sign that said it was.
Also, what position are you in where people would ever read it?
See the coffin shadow through my.
Turn it down a little bit. The music, keep
this
it
is
on.
This is my sign off pose.
But like whatever what position are you ever in where you're doing that? You're holding on for dear life to the side of a building while you're parkouring.
No, and it's not. Also, by the way, your right arm should be further over to the left than your left arm.
There we go. So
it's
whenever Jay is going, yeah, boy.
Oh, and my b-boy stance, it reads nice. What's up, y'all? I'm just in my buffalo stance, waiting for a train.
Has anyone ever recognized it and said, "Oh shit, I love that record"?
Not one person. Zero people in like 8 years.
I had a feeling.
That record really
even when
Jay.
You're standing like this, no one recognizes it.
Even when I'm in my b-boy stance,
to get people to notice.
Yeah, even when I'm hanging on, waiting to get on the linoleum so I can do my spins. They can't lure me to Broadway if I'm gonna go see Broadway.
What if they did Korn live?
No, I'm gonna go see Cornball fucking. Broadway.
Oh yeah.
If I go to Broadway, I want to see not Cornball, but if I'm gonna go, I'm gonna go see the theatrical
get
Phantom
your
of the
hands
Opera
up,
or the
get
fucking.
Get your legs down, everybody.
I would never go see that. What you're doing, but I would go see a. If I'm going to the theater to see a play, it doesn't have to be. Don't try to. I don't want to see like the Marilyn Manson play. It sounds stupid to me.
Beautiful People, written by Marilyn Manson, opening on Broadway with Chesney LaFleur.
It's hard to think who you hate the most. The beautiful people. The beautiful people.
I'm gonna be beautiful.
It's all so common as the size of your steeple.
And also coming this fall to
Broadway, fascism will take it away.
It's the Antichrist superstar like you've never seen him. Marilyn Manson is.
I don't like the drugs, but the drugs like me.
Take this rib out of me. I gotta suck my own dick.
I gotta suck my own dick. How can I suck it with all these ribs in the way? I'm just a boy with too many ribs. Too many ribs to get my penis in my mouth. My parents say I'm crazy. Everyone will say I'm rude.
That's the boy with too many ribs. That's the boy with too many ribs.
I just want to be left alone.
Oh, dude, I love it. Marilyn Manson, beautiful people.
Society's not ready for my idea.
Bravo! What a journey
that
took us on.
I guess I'm just a demon.
boy.
Oh, yes. Marvelous. Bravo. Bravo. Oh, dude, I say we pitch it. Let's fucking get this shit made. Oh, let's get some financiers.
I can see on the back of a bus.
Hell yeah. Just in a cat.
Like a beautiful person.
Yeah, the beautiful person.
Marilyn Manson.
And it's just his eye. It's the weird eyes.
Yeah, it's the weird eyes. Yeah.
A man with
Rose
tits.
McGowan, she's making me crazy. Rose McGowan, she's driving me nuts.
Rose McGowan, she's wearing chainmail. She's Rose McGowan, and she's mine.
Stop showing your muff to the press. I wanna keep something for home.
A man with boobs. A man with boobs. We can't allow a man with boobs.
God is just an illusion.
Oh, man.
Marilyn Manson's Mechanical Animals. Because there's a little bit of animal in all of us.